I'm well, Mariam. I've missed you a lot. Not really had vacation, but that's okay. We're preparing to get you by guys back in school. Everything's been good. How have your vacation?
As you know, the stress of the IGCSE preparation is over. So I'm just spending my time relaxing, just recharging to start the AS level next year. Question one, what are the IGCSE?
The IGCSEs are your basic International General Certificate of Secondary Education. So this is your first qualification of British curriculum, and it's your first external qualification that counts in your career. It is that qualification which is sat at the end of your year 11. It has 2 years of studies behind it, the year 10 and the year 11. In the UK, these are called as the GCSEs, and in the past, they were called the O-levels. These are equivalent to any board exam that a student of any other board would sit for. These are your first external exams. So these are your IGCSEs.
Question number two. People don't really know what is like IGCSE, AS, A-level, Edexcel and Cambridge studies. So can you like give a brief summary about it?
The British curriculum is a curriculum that is very international and very progressive, and there are several boards which offer the British curriculum. You have your Cambridge, you have Edexcel, Pearson's, then there is AQA, etc. Now in our school we use the boards which are the Cambridge board as well as the Edexcel board. These are the two boards that we use. That means these are the qualifying bodies. These are the boards which give us the question papers. When a student passes the exam, this is the board which, the qualifying body which gives the certificate to the students. But the IGCSEs are actually examinations. These are actually secondary examinations which are written after 2 years of study, the year 10 and the year 11. Then in year 12, the student sits for the advanced subsidiary, and in year 13, we have the A-levels. So the name of the exams are the IGCSE, AS and the A-levels, it's one of the premier curriculums across the globe, and we are very happy to say that we've been successfully been able to provide this sort of education to all our students.
Question number three. So what choices do we as Alexander School offer?
A rich and varied syllabus. Certain subjects are compulsory, such as English, Arabic as a second language for non-Arabs. We've got Islamic studies, social studies, geography, Bahrain citizenship, physical education. These are all compulsory subjects, German and many more. But there are certain subjects which are optional, that means you can choose three from, and those are physics, chemistry, biology and business studies. We also have accounts and economics in year 12 and 13, which are options. And lastly, we have ICT, which is compulsory in year 10 and year 11. So these are the choices that we offer.
Question number four. So you as Dr. Saba, what subjects do you recommend?
Which subjects do I recommend? That's a really tough question. Also because I come from a science background and I do not want to sound biased, but every subject has its own advantages, and every subject is beautiful in its own way. Students have their own aptitudes and interests. The subject that you choose have to be the subjects that you see yourself working with in your futures.
So, are the IGCSEs compulsory and are they tough?
The IGCSEs are compulsory, very, very compulsory. Every student who wishes to sit for year 12 or go on to year 12 in some school will have to write the IGCSEs. They're mandatory. Whether they're tough, I think, Mariam, you're the right person to answer this.
Actually, if you work hard, nothing's tough. First of all, you need to plan, practice past papers. At this time, especially in year 10, your teachers are your best friends. So get an advice from them and you'll be fine.
Mariam, I have a few questions for you. Firstly, what is your advice for the year 10 students who are coming in to year 10?
First of all, as you mentioned, choose your subject that you see in your future career. Year 10 may be a new challenge for you, more load, so be serious, don't stress, and remember, you're gonna finish half of your IGCSE curriculum in this.
Okay, so Mariam, my question is, you just finished your year 11 and it was a fight, it was a challenge. This year was difficult. What is the advice that you're gonna give to the incoming year 11 batch, those who will be writing the IGCSEs this year?
Year 11, you've reached half your way there. You've finished half of your curriculum. Stay focused. Don't waste your vacation. Keep practicing. Have a plan and work hard. Keep challenging yourself. Work hard for the moment. You have to end this year with everything. Remember to have a schedule and be on track.